Okay, so Vidit, what are you going to show me today?
Well, I get a lot of questions asked on how do you analyze your game. So I thought why not to share a process of a game which I've not yet analyzed completely. So I wanted to tell how a player goes through, in my opinion, should go through a game after he has played, how he can learn from it.
So what do you mean that you haven't yet analyzed this game?
This game happened on the last round of the Czech League which I just played. And in my opinion, I had advantage, but I let it go. So it'll also be very instructive to see where I went wrong and what I can learn from it. So I've not checked it with engine. So I thought I'll show you what all I saw during the game, because after the game I also briefly analyzed with my friend teammate Marcus Rager. So all these thoughts, like what I saw, and then how computer laughs at us at the end, but also what I can learn from it basically.
So like, you haven't seen this game with a computer?
Not yet, no.
Not yet. So what we are going to do essentially is we are going to look at this game just without any engine.
Yeah.
You'll show your thought process.
Yeah.
And then we'll look at it with the engine.
Yeah, I mean, how I also analyze with engine.
Right.
I mean, what all I learned from it basically. So first I'll show you what I saw during the game.
Okay.
Briefly, and then we check with engine how it is, because I already had for one look with Marcus, right?
Okay.
Shall we start?
Yeah.
So, I played e4, and it was a morning round.
You're playing against
Ftáčnik. I think I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right. Sorry if I'm pronouncing it wrongly.
I think it's Ftáčnik, but it starts with an F.
Yeah.
And he's a very experienced player.
Indeed. He also writes a lot of commentaries for ChessBase. And it for me it was easy to predict that he'll play knight off, because that's the only line he played for e4.
And you began with e4, so
yeah, actually I felt that day playing e4, so it was just it was also last round. I had no time to prepare, because the previous game my game lasted for around 6 hours against Mosisian, which was also terrible, so I was not in a good mood. So I thought, why not e4? Knight f6, knight c3, e6, bishop e3, e5. It's so much fun to analyze. I mean, look at chess on board nowadays. It's become so rare.
Actually, do you have a chess board at home? Because many top players don't even have a chess board.
No, not only at home, I always carry it with me.
Ah, you carry it?
Carry it. Because I played in Chinese League now. And after the games, we used to sit with a chess board. Apparently, I was the only one who had a chess set. So, I was the alien there. And we used to sit on in someone's room, and then we analyzed the games of entire team. It was a lot of fun. Actually, we enjoyed it, and we used to get very hungry after that, especially Nihua, who used to get tired after checking the game for long. And then it was like really enjoyable. I like to play in teams where we have such discussions, and this atmosphere matters to me a lot. I enjoy it more if I'm playing with someone who are my friends and who like chess and are passionate about it. So this is the basic portion of English attack.
You know, I have one question here. Maybe I'm a complete beginner because I don't play the knight off with black. I don't play e4 with white. But you know, the main idea of black in Sicilian is to play d5, and you're getting d5 here without, it doesn't look anything wrong. Why not to play it?
There is something wrong.
Okay.
I mean, it's, you're underdeveloped for to carry this advance.
Okay.
I can just take e d5, knight d5.
Yeah.
Knight d5, and queen d5. Let's say takes, long castle, and I mean, white is completely developed, and you have no development at all.
And white, this square is also a little weak.
Definitely. Bishop e6, knight c5, knight a5. It's just just black is underprepared for this advance.
And just if you take with the bishop here, it doesn't matter. Yeah, you can go c4 and just take.
Not sure if you can go c4, but maybe you can play queen d2, as you cannot take here yet.
Queen d2 and
long castle. Yeah. h5. This is very standard. No, I play knight d5. One game he had played knight d5 earlier on in Slovakian League, but I expected that he'll go bishop d5, e d5, knight d7, queen d2.
What did you?
G6 maybe looks logical.
Yeah. No, I mean I know the theory. I'm just remembering exactly how it went. What move order? I think he played G6, long castle. I had one game here with white where Korobov played knight B6 yes. against me.
Yeah, that was a very critical game. Yeah, of Tata Steel Challengers.
No. That this was Poikovsky.
Ah, Poikovsky. And then you went something like Bishop G5 and
yeah.
It was a draw, but you were better.
No, I won
that. Won that game. You were better, clearly.
Yes. I've analyzed it also in ChessBase. So I think it must be in the database analyzed. He played Rook C8, which confused me a little bit because he's mixing two or three plans. I mean, either you go, for example, Qc7 earlier, or Rook C8 directly. But he made like G6 and Rook C8. It's very rare. I mean, entire point is, for example, if I go Knight B6, I cannot go C4.
Mm-hmm.
For example, and I was unsure what his idea is of Rook C8, but he played quite quickly. So what first thing which I'll do now when I'm analyzing is to check this move, because I don't recall this. It was new, so I'll check if it made sense or it was just his over the board feeling and if it's correct or wrong. So I'll check this when I'm analyzing the game. King B1. This made sense to me because now Knight B6. I have Queen A5. And if what they do is if the rook is here. Black plays Bishop H6.
Ah.
So this is the pin. So this is the difference here. So that's why I was confused. Why Rook C8? Because now I even get King B1. He can't even go Knight B6. And now he played Queen C7. He mixed three plans in one. They either go Queen C7, G6, and Rook C8 is actually quite rare. So, because sometimes in the lines, Black even goes Long Castle. So now that option is gone.
So in a way, he's just messed it up in the opening, you can see.
In my opinion. Yeah, that's what I thought during the game. I have to check it.
Yeah, you haven't checked it yet. And maybe a move like this makes sense now, or this is too much?
C4 was the most natural reaction. But the thing is, I knew some lines where they don't play C4. The point is, now that the rook is here, let's say he can play C4. If I play C4, I thought he'll play B6. Because sometimes C5... can come knight c5 dc d6, which can be annoying. So b6, now this is blocked, so a6, I'm not able to take advantage of it, and he can play knight c5. Basically, usually, like in this lines, it's pretty common that Black will go a5 a4, then knight goes a1 c2 a3 b5. I knew that such ideas exist, but in that game I thought, why to allow it? And I played Rook C1, which is like a little bit extra cautious move. Because now he was actually threatening Knight B6. So I had to take care of it either by Rook C1 or... Although, I'm not sure if Knight B6 was a threat. Because I can always play C4, I think. Knight C4, Bishop C4, Queen C4, Rook C1 is there in the end. So maybe I could have even played something like Bishop E2, which I did.
Yeah. But okay, this looks logical. You want to...
Yeah, at least overprotect this.
Yeah.
Now he played Bishop G7. I played Bishop E2. So, I was out of my book. But I knew that I should be better. Because I had analyzed this position a little bit. And I feel that mixing of all these plans is not correct. That's what I feel right now. Bishop E2 and... Okay, now he cannot push here. B5 is always met with C4. Knight B6 doesn't make sense. So basically he played castle. Only plan left. But now I get in G4.
Yeah, this looks...
This looks really good. Now he played Rook E8, which was a bit strange. I thought... I was more worried of him playing more directly. Okay, B5 doesn't make sense. I always have C4. So the only plan which I thought... GfG94. I'm sure that computer will suggest here that white is better, but it was not easy to spot exactly how concretely. Now there are moves like Queen D3, Queen B4 or Queen E1. Queen F5 also exists, but I don't really want to exchange queens. So what I was thinking was Queen B4, now that I have C2 protected, because Queen D3, I didn't want him to exchange the knights. and he gets free play now. Queen a3, b5, b4, with this bishop might open, the diagonal might open anytime.
And you are a bit slow to do this.
So queen b4. Now if he plays knight c5 or something, I have time. I can play g4 or something. That's what I thought. But f5, it looks very risky to open up here. I admit, it looks very risky. But if it works, it would be fantastic. Like for example, I saw some line gf, rook g1. Now I was thinking knight f6. If bishop h6, then rook f7. Now that my rook is tied here, I could not really double it.
And to consider this for black is also quite difficult because
indeed,
in a way you are just opening up everything.
I mean in this line, I didn't see anything concretely.
And you think black is doing okay?
I mean during the game, I was not sure what plan should I make here. For example, I was thinking I had ideas of like rook f1 to take on f5. Take queen e4. I think more than material what mattered here is that I have free piece play. Now f4 is not possible, knight cannot come here.
Maybe something like
Yes. This was there. This was which was bothering this line.
It's very weird, like this central clump is...
But I have some ideas, maybe I can take go queen h4. And while I was thinking, calculating this line, I could not come to a conclusion because he played rook e8. So this is one thing which I'm surely planning to check with computer to see my assessment here.
Right, so the main point is...
Even my variations which I saw, I want to recheck with computer to know if what I saw makes sense or what went wrong in my calculation.
This is the critical move according to you in your game.
Not critical move, it's one of the lines.
Right.
Because rook e8 what he played, somehow I feel it's too slow. Now, I consider briefly taking on h5 and stuff, but he plays knight h5 and I don't see...
Play. Yeah, you don't have anywhere to kind of do this.
So it helps him.
So you win g5.
Yes.
But then you're closing down the...
Yeah, I closed down this side, but now his pieces are cramped. He has actually no plan right now.
So you will start playing now c4, c5.
Yes. Exactly, that was my idea. Now I played a little bit overcautious move. I played h4. I don't really like it, what I played. I mean, it might be a good move, but I think what makes more sense is play rook g1. I wanted to support this beforehand, because for example, I'll give you...
Why not this move? I'm just... Are you maybe b6 is what is...
Again, b6.
And then you don't have any way to proceed, yeah?
Yeah, and he again puts this knight to c5, which is kind of annoying. What I understood by thinking over the board is that I need this knight or some piece on e4. If I get it here, then I'm completely strategically winning.
So already do this and
yes,
this.
Yes. Yeah. So this was my idea. Now, let's say I, for example, knight c5.
Mm-hmm.
There are some ideas where I take with the bishop, but then this pawn will be hanging.
So that's why
I played this, so that I want to carry out this idea.
Right.
And then I don't want, but it's, I think, too cautious. Even if I wanted this to be defended, I should have played this. So I stop his f5 ideas or f6 ideas. If it will be open and then g6 will be weak always.
Right.
So I think rook g1 made more sense. And the other option was to directly go queen b4 or queen a5, which I did eventually in the game. So I played h4. Not so happy with it, but I think it should be fine. Not really a bad move. Knight f8. I mean, what can he do actually? I don't see any plan.
Yeah.
e4 is always met with f4. And I thought his idea was to play knight c5.
Okay.
Yes, somehow. This is the only active plan I could see. So, for example, queen b4, I did not like knight c5.
Because when you take, he gets a tempo attacking your queen.
Yes. I think still white is better after this, but I wanted to play something which is more clear. I think I played a good move, queen a5.
But if
queen d3 is, I think, not good move. e4 will come with a tempo.
Like the
now it's f4 is there.
Sacrifice and then
knight
e5. The knight on
e5. Oh, I would never allow this in my wildest dreams.
Queen a5.
So my thinking was, if I exchange queens, strategically I'm much better. I have two bishops, I have more space, and my plan is very clear. Let's say if you exchange, I play c4, b4, c5. Now I can freely extend on this side.
Sure. Yeah, once the queen is off, you...
Just, and he has only one idea, e4 has always met with f4. So I thought strategically I'm doing excellent right now. And now if he plays knight c5, h4 is useful because queen c7, rook c7, bishop c5 for example, pc. Now I go knight d2, knight d4. I can also go d6 ideas, rook d1, d6. But I saw this and I thought white is better. I have more than one way, knight d2, knight e4.
Maybe when you go queen f5, you can sacrifice the pawn with b6 or no?
He can, but what after that? Yeah, queen a6? Right. Rook a8, queen b5, and just... I mean, I play a3 and there is no attack whatsoever.
So this is just plain bad.
Yeah, yeah. This is not how it... I think at this point, computer will show white is clearly better.
Mm-hmm.
This is what I feel. And white should be better.
So you are the stronger player in the game. Like, you are almost 200 points above him, yeah?
Mm.
And you also have a better position here. So what went wrong? Like, this is your type of position. You're kind of milking him.
I'll show you what went wrong. I think one mistake led to another and slowly I lost control of the game. So f5, he played. I think, no one likes this weakening here, but...
Yeah, sure. And I think you should take, yeah?
Yeah, because I cannot allow this. Knight f6. Yeah, knight f6. Now I think I could have this part, after this part, I could have played better. I think so far I built up the game correctly, I could not exploit it correctly. This was my mistake. And this is one moment which I want to check very carefully with computer. So what I do is I'll identify the critical points.
This is a critical moment according to you.
Yes.
Why do you think this is the critical moment?
First of all, I think somewhere there is a change in the type of situation. First it was a strategic position, I was just slowly improving. But now things have changed. Major decision happened on f5, takes. Now I have to make a choice of a plan again. It's not like I'm just following a plan which I already made. So I have to play c4, c5, or I can play for this weakness. I can avoid the queen exchange now to play against this weakness, or I can exchange. So there's a lot of options. And usually here, when there are a lot of options, chances of going wrong are higher because you might not choose the best option.
But maybe here white has many good options.
Yes,
yeah,
yes. That's why it was tough to know what should I play. I played c4, which makes sense because I don't want to exchange queens yet. Maybe I could take and play c4 as well. But okay, you have to go with your instincts sometimes.
Sure.
You cannot always plan stuff. My point was, now if he brings this knight to stop c5, rook g1, or I can just stop the queen exchange and now start playing against this.
Yeah, this now this become, because this knight is gone.
Exactly.
You already have...
Yes. So c4, and I was keeping the option of not exchanging the queens.
Also for him to take means he has to
give
waste tempo.
This
and you get
b4. I don't know if I should play b4 immediately, but it's an option.
Yeah.
So he played king h7, which I also expected him to play. Because this is a very standard idea to exchange this bishop. It will at least reduce some pressure from this position. Now, I'm not happy with my decision. So I think... objectively, even though it might be correct, practically, I think I went wrong here. I think rook d1, which I played.
You want to go c5 and defend this.
Yes.
But it seems wrong. Why?
No, it's not wrong. Objectively, it's correct. But I complicated the things for myself. What I should have done is take on c7. To simpler, in a game, which I think is the most practical, take and play rook d1. My plan is very clear. I want to play c5. He cannot stop it in one go.
Yeah. Maybe you are a little bit tense that he might exchange one piece.
Yes. But what lines I saw, I'll show you. c5. dc. Now I first of all get a tempo with this. d6. Rook c8. Okay, rook c6 is an option. But rook c8, let's say. Knight c5. Knight c5. Now... Bishop c5. This is what I saw later on. I only saw rook c5. Then I take bishop c5, knight d7. But bishop c5 is good. Because if he plays bishop h6, which was bothering me, I mean, some lines, I have d7.
Yeah.
Intermezzo. So now knight d7, now I go bishop e3 back.
Mm-hmm.
Now the threat is rook c7, which is extremely annoying.
Yes.
And with this pawn, with two bishops, and if I get this, okay, it's finished. Or if I go bishop f1, bishop h3, it should be very good. And it's very annoying because he will lose one of the pawns. And where is his play? e4, f4 is coming. I feel white should be better and easier to play in the game.
Yeah.
This is what I should have gone for.
Yes.
My idea was to again keep... this is what I wanted to do, but a move later. I wanted him to commit with some plan. Like rook d1. Now I wanted him to commit knight d7. Then I wanted to have a think. Should I go queen d2? Or maybe I can take... I wanted to have more options. Which I feel is a bit... unnecessary. I should have taken rook d1.
Yeah,
I have this clarity and go.
More, trying to be a little more over prophylactic, which was or overthinking.
Yeah, overthinking. I mean, objectively it's correct, I think, because he played queen d7.
Ah, he kept the queens.
He kept the queens. Now, I still think white is clearly better.
But is it, can't you now just go this?
Also, one more thing which I want to check is. Ragar after the game was always trying this plan of bringing the knight to g8. To e7 to f5. So I want to check in some lines he showed me this. So during analysis I'll remember to check this. I didn't believe in it, whereas he thought that if the knight comes to f5 it'll be fine. I just felt that it's a bit too slow.
Mm-hmm.
I'll get in c5 or something or the other. And he showed in various plans, like after queen d7 and without queen d7. So I want to check this as well. So usually what I do is when I after analyze my game with my opponent or someone, I try to put those thoughts and have
sure.
a recheck as well. So
you take those options also seriously in your...
Just to improve the understanding in general.
Right.
Makes sense to check. Why not? Because
yeah.
computer will not show this maybe. Maybe it's not a good move. So that's why you'll miss it. But over the board human thought this. To check it. Why not? And my conclusion. If I strongly felt that this is wrong. Because it's too slow. I strongly felt it. So I want to check if my feeling was correct or not.
Correct.
So he played queen d7. Now I think I should have played queen b6. So this is another critical moment which I want to cross check with computer again. So what I do is I identify these moments. After the game I know, okay, maybe I should have played this, maybe I should have played that. So these moments are very fresh in my mind. Those moments I want to spend more time on than other.
You know, the problem which I find in a lot of people is that what is fresh for you is fresh, like for you maybe it's fresh for a week. Because you have a good memory, you are a stronger player. But for, let's say, club players or players who have a lower rating, for them the period is smaller. Like they can remember
okay.
only for 3 hours, 4 hours.
So you can check after the game, no? I
yes.
mean, you can analyze the game with your opponent. Even if you don't want to analyze during the tournament, your games, you can just put your thoughts, okay.
Do you think that spends a lot of energy in your... Because today itself, this... Ramesh, who is India's coach and also you played at the Olympiad where he was the trainer, he has put this post on Facebook saying when to analyze your games.
Mm-hmm.
Immediately after it's over, after the tournament is over. And this is a big question because what you're saying right now, these things which are fresh in your mind and all, it goes away, it fades away actually after a point. So when do you put it?
Well,
because energy is lost, yeah, like in doing this, all of this.
No, I usually don't check immediately with computer. Sometimes I do because I'm very curious. If I missed a win, clear win, I want to know about this. And then I just make myself feel bad. That's not really a great idea. What you can do is just put your thoughts. Okay, during the game I thought this, thought that. If you don't remember it after a while. Because you might not remember. For example, knight g8 I remember now. Which Marcus was telling all the time. I mean, I don't think it takes more than 10 to 15 minutes to just put your thoughts. You don't even need to type it. If you just put the variations also, you'll remember.
Right.
But I think I've seen people typing it, their thoughts. Okay, I prefer this. Sometimes people don't analyze the games at all and they're still strong players. So, I mean, to each his own.
Yeah, sure.
There are some players who don't analyze like with computer so seriously. Okay, they'll just check with computer and leave it or something. It's also possible.
So here he went queen d7.
Yeah, I just want to tell that what I'm doing is not the right way. It's just
sure.
a way.
It's a way, and if people find it comfortable, they
yeah.
can follow it.
Yeah. It's my style too.
It has worked for you, but in the past.
No, this not worked. I enjoy it.
Yeah.
No, this is the only way I enjoy it. Otherwise, some interactive part should be there. Otherwise, I don't enjoy just checking the lines with computer. I feel it's very boring. And also to find out how wrong I was in my game. That's fun always to know.
What I see very interestingly in you is that you want to constantly check whether what you thought during the game was correct or not.
Yeah, my analysis. Because then I'll know, okay, if this is somewhere when I'm going wrong, maybe it's a pattern. I have to improve on this part of the game. Something like this. It's easier. It becomes easier to identify what. The main point of analyzing a game, I feel, is to learn from your mistakes. And to know your strengths. Basically, know yourself better. You get to know yourself, your style better.
Right.
So, that's the main point of analyzing the game. So, I think your queen b6, I should have played. The ideas are like c5. I mean, here c5 was there, but I didn't take it too seriously. Because dc, knight c5, queen f5. Bishop d3, then queen f3 is there. And if king a1, e4. I saw this and I felt it's too complicated to... I mean, it might work, but I didn't really like so much f4 than knight d5. If fe, knight e4, bishop d3 or something, queen e5. And I felt it was a bit too messy, unnecessarily. Why to give him so much counterplay? And I played king a1, which was just like a prophylactic move. But I feel queen b6 is a strong move.
Mm-hmm.
Now I'm threatening c5 again. Also, I have ideas like knight f5 attacking this. Somehow, it's just like a move which improves your position a little bit. Keeps all the plans in hand. And queen f5, king a1, I saw there are some ideas like knight d7. If I take this, bishop f8, queen is trapped. But I think I can just take here. And if rook b8, to go queen c6, not to open another file also. Just should be clearly better for me.
Yeah.
So, there was no objective reason why I rejected it. I got confused between two options and I think I chose the inferior one, king a1. Because queen h3 or something, I'll give this pawn, I don't care about this. I just either collect everything here or even I have rook h1 in the worst case. So I was not really worried and I didn't see anything else for him. But he played this e4 because always after f4, the point was, let's say the queen was here, knight g4, there was bishop g4, hg4. And this pawn is very weak. I could just go rook g1 and usually collect it.
Yeah.
Or this, after this, there was complete blockade. But things had changed. Now his queen was here. So I just...
If you take, he takes with queen.
And now he's having, first of all, I missed the idea that he has rook c4. Rook c4 and then d1 is hanging. Now I feel there was a big change in situation. I think the evaluation will change here.
Maybe do this, then he can take this guy.
Also queen e2. Now this is mate threatened.
Yeah.
It's completely going
the
bizarre.
The tide is sort of shifting, yeah?
Suddenly without a bishop my position is very fragile. Now this side is very fragile. So I didn't like this change. I was unhappy. And I want to see. I think the evaluation will change. It will not be the same.
So
I think king a1 is maybe...
A1, yeah.
I don't like it.
And then e4 you didn't consider is very seriously.
Yeah, it was very good move. I missed this because f4, knight g4... Now his queen is very active.
This compared to
the endgame which I was showing, which he had no play. And I was just pushing, probably clearly better. So I was like thinking why I did this, why I did not do it.
And this happens to you in the game, you keep regretting and...
Now the time is shorter. I regret for few seconds and then I let it go. Because usually I'm short on time. Also, I want to check if options like bishop d4, which I rejected during the game, how are those?
Good, yeah.
I didn't want to... allow this blockade to open up. But it makes sense to exchange this bishop. I'll briefly check these moves and stuff. Before queen g4. Okay, now queen b6 and all were possible, but rook c4 is there. Queen b4 was possible, for example, to attack these two. I think this might be a good move, but I didn't like b5. I don't know why. Maybe cb, ab, just simple opening up. Queen d6, queen e2 ideas. Looks a bit messy now.
Yeah.
But maybe objectively queen b4 could be the right move. Queen d2 is what I played, stopping rook c4. And I thought if he takes this pawn, I'll always have rook h1, f5, some counterplay or the other. I was expecting queen h4, but he played knight d7, which I was slightly surprised with. Also, one more thing is, I always note down the timings of how much I took on some moves. So I check that as well when analyzing.
Okay.
How much time?
So you write like first move 90, then 89.
Yeah. I think I'm the only player who does it. It's too annoying to do it, but I got this habit.
This one now? Or no? You didn't play
I played rook tune, which is most, but I was confused between knight d4 as well. Knight d4, knight c5. The thing is, I cannot always go f5 because this knight comes here. I did not like it. I'm just showing this at this point just to show this idea of knight d5. Knight d4, knight c5, I did not like. I mean, rook g1, I considered this for a long time.
Yeah, because you might get f5 next.
Exactly. And queen h4, something like this. Now ideas like rook g6. I feel that this is also good, knight d4. Might be even better. So this is one thing which I want to see if my calculation let me wrong or my intuition let me wrong here. Because there were ideas like rook g6. If I play king g6, rook g1, king f7, rook g7. You cannot take knight f5, knight h4, but king f8. Looks a bit risky, and I always have this problem with back rank. Yeah. Queen g2, queen e1. So I'm not really sure. Also, rook g6 is not the only move, of course. f5 was the main move. Knight d3. fg6, king g8. Now I felt that this pawn, somehow my attack is not so smooth. But there is rook f1. Still complicated.
Yeah.
Rook c4 is there. Then knight f5. I mean, just the lines just don't stop. But I feel still, my intuition says that white is better here. So I think this was one moment where I could be wrong, where I played rook g1. I spent some considerable amount of time. So knight d4 makes sense. Now the difference is I played the same thing, rook g1. Also there was one point like knight d4, rook g1, queen h4, rook g6, bishop d4 is also one move. Which I have to check if it works or something. So rook g1, now queen h3 is what I didn't expect him. I thought he'll take.
Yeah.
And now I was calculating long lines. Long lines are always wrong lines.
Well, I also feel like player like Ftáčnik, who is more strategically inclined, or you know, like he's not at the same, let's say, calculation wise. He will look for options which are much more different from, like, I don't know, here there will be a lot of lines to calculate and...
Maybe. It's only he knows what he's wanted.
Sure.
We can just speculate what he wanted. Also, he played this very quickly, so I think it was an intuitive decision, not based on calculation. Because queen h4, there are lines like queen g2. I think all the pretty lines are behind the scenes usually. For example, queen f6, bishop d4, queen f7, then f5, I was thinking. Looked very interesting. Queen f5, rook df1. Now initially I just thought that okay, now the queen is trapped because queen g4. First I thought that rook f7 ideas I have, but then he has knight e5. Then I saw queen h2. Now his queen is trapped. But.
Yeah.
But what do you think? Rook f8.
Cool.
The lines kept going on. Might be white is winning, but I have to again forced myself.
Yeah, it's not easy.
So there is another point is to go queen h1. But then again queen e2. It's like, what is going on? Is there a win or not? Till the time I could figure out he played. Also, I think after bishop d4, queen f5 was also one thing which I was bothered about. Now I don't have f5, so I take king g7, knight d4. Now queen f7. F6, F5. If he takes, then it's just queen g6 and it's mate. So knight e5, something like this. And it goes on, but I was expecting this kind of variations to happen. So queen h3 was a bit of a surprise. And so I play knight d4. I want to play f5 next. The point is, if he plays knight c5, again to get the same thing, I'll play f5 first. to stop his queen from going back. Gf5, rook h1. Now queen g4 or something, then this comes. The queen is trapped. I cut off his way. So knight c5 didn't work. And I was expecting him to go knight f6. Because I thought this is the plan. To put the knight here. And there are a lot of variations like f5, then knight g4. fg6, now king g8 was the main thing. If king g6, then this is pinned. So I can put my knight on e6 and stuff like this. So there are a lot of intricacies. But the thing is, this does not concern me so much. Because it was not in my hands to make this decision. But of course, I'll check it anyways. So I put more focus on my decisions when analyzing the game. He played knight b6, attacking this pawn. I cannot play rook h1 as well. Something, take on c4. So b3 was the only move. I didn't want to open this. But now again, I'm threatening to just play king b1 or f5. Now he played back knight d7. Point is again to bring this knight here.
He played interestingly, yeah?
Yeah.
This phase of the game.
Yeah, and I think he felt comfortable here. So I think it was more important to take on c7 and go to endgame. He was enjoying this position.
So you did this.
King b1. And now here there was an interesting point to play rook h1 first. Now this pin is there, so he can come back queen f5. Queen g4 is rook g1, so queen f5. Now rook g1. Because if I play king b1 attacking this, he will take queen d4 and then again put knight on g4. Then I have no entry points. So here it was important to play rook dg1. Now he cannot go knight f6 because now I can take.
Sure.
Spin is there. But I didn't like queen f7 here. And I had low on time, so I was not sure. For example, f5, then I take and stuff like this. So I'll check this line carefully because I feel this is critical. But I played king b1 anyways because it's similar to what I'd seen. Again, I played knight e6. I don't like this decision again. I get an exchange, but now I think already it was too complicated. For example, f5, knight g4, this king g8. Now I think I saw some lines like knight f5, knight e3, knight g7. But I did not see winning prospects here. King g7, rook c3, queen h4, rook e3. And I thought something like rook e5 or something. Equal pawns, and I didn't see winning prospects. I was still ambitious, so I felt I should try for more. But again, this is another lines. I think this was another one of the critical moments, this area around this, because a lot of things are happening.
Yeah.
So mainly it's in analysis, it's identifying the critical areas. That's one of the main things. Then you analyze it. First you learn from the openings, what went wrong, rook c8, this subtleties. Then the critical moments where you feel you went wrong, like this. So you learn from this. This is where some major changes happen in the position. Anyways, so knight e6 I played, not so happy with it. B6. I think objectively white might be better, but now it's very easy for black to play. Put the knight here, put the rook behind the pawn, d5 ideas, b5 ideas. Whereas my plans, if I get this, I'm winning completely. If I get the f5 break, I did not see it. And now we both were in time pressure, so the quality dropped heavily. At least from my side, dropped heavily. Rook e8. Now I played very bizarre and strange moves. I was expecting him to go bishop h6. I want to see if this was correct. But I think what he played is also good, rook e8. Now, I didn't want him to block this, so I played queen c3, so I pinned this. But even if I want to do this, queen b2 is a better square. I'll tell you why, because queen c3, e3 is coming. And I think after analysis with Marcus, I thought maybe rook on e1 here is better, because anyways this will come, and the rook has nothing to do. So I think if I played this, I'm still slightly better, maybe.
Yeah.
Or it's equal, dynamic equal. But now I lost the thread of the game completely, and I know for sure it's bad. Even if computer says, I am sure, like 100% it will show that this is bad move. E3. What I missed was rook e1. I wanted to attack this. Queen e4. King b2, then knight d5 is coming.
Oh.
If the same position with queen on b2, there is no tempo. So if I had to do this, I should have gone queen b2. But still there is rook e7. And then knight on g4. Still, it's complicated, but
sure.
Comparatively, this is like the worst move of the game. Queen c3, e3. Now, I played king a1 to remove this check. Now, I think black is better.
Yeah.
He could have played rook e7,
He also has this possibility.
He played knight e4 in the game. He played this in the game.
He blundered, yeah?
I'll show you. I'll keep some suspense. But I think rook e7 or something he could have played with the idea knight g4 to support this. Or play queen f5 and then rook e4. Take with the rook. Now I was worse in this position.
Sure.
I think it's already clearly better for black. So when he played knight e4, I was indeed happy. Queen e3.
No. I think
queen e3. Knight c5. Knight c5 is queen c3.
Ah, you
wish
to go back.
Yeah. But knight g5.
Knight g5.
If takes queen e3, I cannot do anything. I have to move the queen.
If you move your queen, then take and knight.
My rook is on c1, right? My rook is on c1,
yeah.
Not on d1. So we're putting the position wrong.
No, it was on c1.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now we put it wrong. So this is the position. Bishop d4, queen d4, knight f3. Okay, now, I was very unhappy. I was pressing throughout the game and then in this complication also, I think maybe I overstretched. I played badly in this phase. So, I just offered draw after queen c3. Takes. I think even your black might do better. My pawns are... His king is safer than my king. That's the main thing.
But this guy, he shouldn't exchange the queens here. Something like this is not good.
Why not? He can do it.
Take and then do this.
Yes, but it's a race. It's a wild race. Rook d6, rook f4, I take this. I think black is faster in this race.
Really?
I think black is faster.
But then your pawn
c5,
is...
rook f4. Connected passed pawn. If this pawn was not there, things might be different. It's not connected. He can stop one pawn easily.
And then these...
These pawns are unstoppable. So I was like, I already had no chance.
So you offered a draw at the right moment.
It was like the 40th move or something, and then he was very tensed in the last few moves. So he immediately accepted it because the pressure was very high. It's a team event. If you lose, it makes a big difference. And for their team, I saw that it works. That it's a draw is fine, and I had no chances of winning anyways now.
Right.
It could be equal, but I don't feel any big chances. So now the fun part is to check the things with computer.
Sure,
let's do that. Yeah.
Right, so let's go over your game with the engine that we just saw right now.
So I'm using Stockfish 10 right now. So I forgot to switch off this contact. Knight d5. Jesus, okay, this variations I have analyzed already, so I know. Mm-hmm. Now we played rook c8. It's a new move, yeah?
Yeah.
For me, at least it was. So, king b1, what I played was correct. So, what I'll usually do is go in reference and find games, look through them and analyze it. But for this video, I will not do that because it will take some time. So I'll just check through this and see what, if anyone has played, did he have any point in this. So king b1 makes sense. Yeah, most logical. Now queen c4, queen c7. Yeah, I think, as I said, this mixing of all these ideas is really not good.
So you already have a plus minus. Do you take this evaluation seriously?
No, at least in this phase not, because I know, but now right now I think the evaluation is correct that I have an advantage. It says rook e1, but I don't really see the point of it and I didn't even consider it. So sometimes here this difference is also, though it's my laptop computer right now, so it will go down, I know, because rook e1 doesn't make any sense. So
rook
what
c1
do,
what you played was the best tricks, move
apparently. Yeah, so good for my ego and confidence. So c4 is one move which I was considering seriously. I'll check. Yeah, b6. As I said, I was worried about b6. Okay, bishop e2, knight c5 maybe. Okay, this was an interesting alternative, but it's not like rook c1 is bad, so I think also possible. Bishop g7. Now later on what I'll do is I'll go deep in this and I'll see why c4, why it shows it's better. I'll try to make more moves later on.
Mm-hmm.
See, knight c5 is not the top choice. It was not showing at least. But I just put because I was worried about such ideas. So I'll go through that. Even this line, first line, looks very interesting, where he gives a rook, for example. So whenever I see some interesting line like this, now Bishop F1 apparently only move. So I'll try to understand. I don't like this for white because it might be better because I have h4 h5 ideas, but he gets some typical knight off play. So I'll check this stuff, but quickly at first glance I'll not go very deep into it. I'll go to the critical moments first. Bishop g7, bishop e2, again c4, then it doesn't make sense with rook on c1, so I'll not check that line. Bishop e2 I think is most logical top choice. Yeah, e4, I think what it's showing, it will change. It will not be maybe the main move. Maybe. Not sure. Because if he plays this, I get f5 ideas. Sorry. I thought this is very comfortable for me. And giving this pawn.
Queen e4, king f8, I mean already it looks...
Maybe I should not take on g4, I was thinking. Yeah, bishop d4 is what I saw. See, I said it'll increase, the evaluation will increase because now if I put this knight g4 might not be later on after a few minutes on better depth. Depth 21 is too little.
How long do you go for a depth to be sure?
Depends on position. Right now, okay, this is a laptop computer, so it's not really... At my home I have a better computer, so I'll check with that. So, already e4, f4 it's showing, it's not in the top 3. Yeah, it didn't make sense, I have clear play. So, castle, which is normal, g4. Okay, now as I said, I wanted to check how to punish this knight e4. Queen b4 was right. f5, gf5, gf5. Okay, now rook f1 is also there. So, my evaluation was not bad. But in general, it's all the lines are like +2, +2.
Yeah, so this is, I mean, what you were saying was rook g1, rook hg1, knight df6, bishop h6.
Rook f7,
which it's not so clear.
Not so strong also.
Now but the so how, what was the better way for you to play after?
It's just knight d2. Very interesting. It exchanges the most active piece. But even this, you know, for me it would not be easy to evaluate this +2 during the game.
Rook g6 and bring the other rook, but it's
not really, maybe rook f1 makes more sense to me, which I saw, and then we saw some knight c5, right?
Yeah.
And now rook g1, now he doesn't have this knight on f6. I like this more, because what he says like a5 giving up the pawn doesn't make sense to me. So knight c5, rook g1.
Yeah, very nice.
Yeah.
But and okay. You learned something.
Yeah, it was interesting.
Yeah.
To see my evaluation. So rook f8 apparently the top choice, g5, knight h7. Yeah, I think this is clearly better. As I said, strategically, now I played h4, which was not too happy, but the evolution will not change because not much.
So the computer doesn't see anything wrong.
So
with
sometimes what I do is I just put this move in the analysis to go back to later and see if it made any difference. So I just put it there. h4, now we play knight f8, makes more sense. This is interesting, bishop d3. I didn't want to allow this e4 pawn sacrifice. I think you said queen d3 right here. Same idea, but now yeah, it's now even it's worse.
The computer also thinks it's good.
But here, the thing is, I don't need to remove the bishop. It's there. It's interesting also strategically to put the bishop on e4. Interesting lines. Rook e1 also I don't understand. See, now it's showing queen a5.
And you played that.
Yeah, so it's nice.
So actually, you played the first phase of the game quite well.
Yes, because it's easier to play this position. So takes, knight f6. Because what else does he suggest? Okay, b6 giving this.
Yeah, b6.
Sometimes what I do is I just read the first line. Sometimes I don't even put it because I can see it. And then I see the final position, I'm not really worried. So also it's about my taste.
Yeah.
I like this line, stuff like this. I know, for example, queen a5, knight a5, it shows it's in the top 3, but I know that it's good. I don't really need to check it. So I'll move to the critical file. And here I know that I misplayed the position. So I want to check this carefully. C4, it says queen d2 as well. But okay, I think on higher depth it will be the same. If the depth increases, probably the valuation will be same. So it's pretty similar, 1.56, 1.25, c4. But as I said, it was all, see now c4 is top choice, I don't know. Queen d2, as I said, to keep the queen was also an option, which was confused about, to attack g6 now. Anyway, c4, which is also not a bad move. I don't think I should be harsh on myself here. King h7, now queen d2. I saw this move during the game. The point is to stop bishop h6, now c5 is threatened, but I thought if he'll play b6, rook at g1, now a5. I didn't like this, that my knight is getting harassed, but I saw queen c2 here. The point is to bring knight d2, knight e4, but I thought he'll go queen f7, now knight d5 is threatened, and then I stopped calculating.
Mm-hmm.
Now it says queen d3. See, I mean, it's not easy. It says rook cd1 a4 to give this pawn on d5 and bring the other. For example, I'll show you this line. It's not at all practical how a human will think during the game. Bishop g5. It gives this pawn, then it allows the other knight to come to d4. So I'll not be harsh on myself for not seeing this.
Yes.
Because it's just not possible.
Do you sometimes feel like the engine, it's very difficult, it shows some evaluation, you give it more time, it changes its evaluation?
It usually does not change so much, because we are doing it a little bit faster now. So, if, when I'm analyzing, sometimes I let it go deeper. But now we are, as it's like first look.
Yeah.
If we spent, what I usually do, if it will be a very, very long video. It won't be
sure.
Really instructive, but I just want to give a glance, like a preview of how it happens. So, first, I'll promote this. I played, here I was thinking queen c7, which I thought I should have played practically. Let's see the evaluation, how it is. Now rook to d1. Here I'll let the engine run for some time to see.
So you would let it go till something like depth 30 or so here.
Mm. Okay, knight g8, what Marcus was saying, it's very bad, apparently.
It's slow.
It's slow, yeah. So this is one thing out. Now knight d7. Okay, bishop h6 is also one move which I have to check. c5. e4. f4. I thought f. See, e4 is important move actually.
Mm-hmm.
Cd6, rook c1, bishop c1, e3. Gets complicated.
Yeah.
Also, now that this knight is blocking this pawn, which I don't really like. I want to get in c6 at least. And if I play f4, now dc. Okay. d6, rook c6. It's not an high evaluation. So maybe what I played was maybe best. Yeah, engine does not like this so much.
Yeah.
It says the drawing chances increase.
It wants to keep the queens, like go back and play. But your opponent actually kept the queens. So you went rook hd1.
It's in top 3 choices, and the evaluation is like 0.1 or something. Rook hd1 is now the top choice. It's now the top choice. So I think what I played, my intuition during the game was right to keep the pressure. Queen d7, again another critical point. See, queen b6 top choice. It's the top choice. I wanted to play queen b6. Yeah, I regret not playing it. Yeah, queen b6, yeah, it's clearly, I told you objectively.
At what point do you think, like, 1.5 means you are usually satisfied that it's like a winning advantage?
No.
Also depends on the position.
Yeah, it depends on some position. 1.5, sometimes 0.5 also in some position is very good advantage.
Here 1.5 doesn't make sense, or you think that here it's pretty solid?
The thing is 1.5, but the position is so dynamic that if I have to be accurate to keep up with the advantage. It's not that the position is not that advantageous.
Yeah.
It's not easy to keep up with that advantage. Yeah, I should have played queen b6. I thought so. This was the mistake. One of the mistakes, I think. I played king a1, which is also top 3. It's not really bad. e4. Now, maybe here is one of my mistakes. I automatically played f4. I didn't even give any thought to bishop d4.
So this is something which you will analyze more closely.
Carefully.
And try to understand why you didn't consider this move. And why you didn't consider this move?
Because it's very standard idea to play f4, because it just helps him open this files, I thought. I mean, these pieces get freedom. Bishop d4 is apparently very strong. Okay, so this is one thing which I'll have to reflect on. To think why I did not even consider this move. I have to be very honest with myself. Be sometimes very critical also.
And
it's interesting. This is one thing which I should reflect on. F4 is the second choice. Let's see. Knight g8. So Marcus's idea was good, but just not in that position.
Yeah.
So this is a new concept also which I learned from analyzing. This maneuvering of the knight to e7 to f5. It didn't come to me during the game.
But now you can go c5, and don't you think it's very you're fast, or it doesn't even touch your pawns?
Interesting. Now this is blocked, no? This side, on the right hand side. Very interesting.
Yeah.
Also, this bishop is open. That's a big difference. Same position with e5, f3, it will not work. Let's see. Knight g8. Now knight d2, knight e4. You just blocked the. This is the difference. So knight g4. So knight g8 was good move. Knight g4. Bishop g4. I think what I played is correct. Bishop d4 was there, but it's second rate as I thought about it. Queen g4. Queen d2 is correct as well. Oh, it's still, I have a big advantage. Yeah. Interesting.
Yeah.
I thought that, yeah, I mean, of course I was better, but I didn't know that this better. I felt a little bit, because the character of the position changed. I was not so happy with it during the game. Interesting, very interesting.
So you went knight d7 here?
G1 again correct. I did not play bad. I just thought that I played bad. Knight d4 second choice. Yeah? Okay, this interesting point, so I'm letting it think for some time. Because depth 20, you cannot take it very seriously. This point. So knight d4 is, it's very close.
Yeah.
So I spent 10 minutes to decide between those, which is correct. Sometimes it's very hard to decide between this 0.10 difference. Human plays
both are
on the
good,
feeling,
yeah?
On the feeling that this feels better to me. Yeah, as I said, knight d4 was also one of the moves which I considered. So I think I was calculating decently during the game. Rook g1, queen h3. His intuition was also right, that not to take the pawn. Now, maybe here queen g2 is not needed. Queen g2. Okay, so what I saw was not bad. No, wait, how did we get the line?
F5, I think you played one move in between, yeah?
No, knight d4 I was playing. No. Here I only saw queen f6, yeah. Queen f6. Now bishop d4 we were checking. Which is not still very good, very good. The line which we saw. Queen f7 takes, knight d4. Queen f5 takes, knight d4, it's the choice. But here, queen f6, knight d4 wasn't probably winning, yeah. Queen h3 and attack goes on. Interesting. So queen h3, knight d4. Yeah, knight f6. I thought he should block this. So I want to know what is the big difference in this way. It's now knight b6 also there. Equivalent apparently. So later on I'll check knight f6 more carefully to see if there is any difference compared to the game. b3 again on knight d6, yeah. Okay, it's bad. b3, knight d7. Yeah, now again I was confused between rook h1 and king b5. It's very similar. I was confused in the positions where both the options were good.
Correct. I think your
king b1 again is the top choice.
You are thinking like Stockfish.
Apparently, till some point. Now again, rook g1 doesn't make sense. Rook g1 again, queen h3. So this is one variation which I thought. Now queen f7.
I saw this bishop d4. I thought bishop d4 I can play, and this position I was unsure. Yeah, b5 gets counterplay. And I did not want to exchange queens. I thought his drawing chances will increase if he exchanges queens. So maybe what I played is not indeed bad. But of course I'll check what was wrong with queen f10, which I thought during the game. Rook g5, bishop f6, which I saw with Marcus as well. Now rook g1. Very interesting concept. It just gives the rook completely. Apparently close to winning. Interesting. So maybe practically maybe this was easier to play. But king b1 is also very normal to get out of the pin. He played knight f6, which is right. Yeah, as I said, f5 I was considering. So let's see what was wrong with f5. Now king g8, yeah. I automatically was taking on g6 all the time. Rook c1. It's very hard. Very hard to play this.
Yeah.
It's very hard to play this.
But what happens if you take on d4? Then you play fg6 intermediate move. Bishop
what?
Into d4.
Sorry? When?
Now, yeah. Rook c1, bishop into d4. Yeah, I wanted to actually, if you take, let's say anything, I wanted to play gf5 and try
but
to...
But e3 also, you wanted to play. Gf5, queen g5? D3 is okay. Queen d3 check is there. But giving this bishop should always be very dangerous. This is very interesting, rook c1. I wonder if... This fg6 is so automatic. It's really automatic. King g8.
And now rook c1 doesn't work here.
Now knight e3 is there. Yeah, I saw this variation during the game and I thought, okay, this bishop, I'm definitely not better. I thought I'm even worse here. But okay, he just goes and takes this bishop.
So actually...
So the difference we have to check is what happens if I play rook this one. Now
knight
e3. Yeah, you can take with the rook now.
So threat was stronger than execution. Like fg6, you don't take it, you just keep it there and the options are open.
It's just because of this subtlety.
Yeah.
This exact thing. It's not easy to see it during game with time pressure. Yeah. Very f5.
Yeah, so you played rook h1?
No, I did not play. I played knight e6. So this is where I went wrong apparently. Queen d7. Five. I saw this, but I thought if the knight comes here, I'm apparently it gives this bishop and says there's a long term attack.
I think this is something for you to you learn from this game, something new things like.
Also, no, I'll check till the end and then draw the conclusions. Yeah, as I said, it's not nice.
Sure.
I'm sure I told you for sure computer will change evaluations. Bishop d4. See, I told bishop h6, he should have played, I thought. Yeah. Because now knight g4 is coming. My calculation during the game was not bad. Yeah, rook c d1. Marcus. No, rook c1.
Rook c1, yeah.
What's wrong with rook c1? What? e3? Rook e3, knight d4. We did not see this. No, I think I already lost control.
Sure.
Anyways, so... Queen c3, very bad move, e3. Black is better. King a1 or something. Yeah, I said queen f5, rook e4. He was better already. Yeah, in the final position, I'm worse.
You're worse by a big margin and maybe the variation which we analyzed was correct, queen e3.
Yeah.
That's the best one, yeah?
Yeah. No, for this point is very important. So
what a game, yeah. I mean you played a good game, but I think at some point you lost the thread of the game.
Yeah. Now I have to draw conclusions of it.
So if you had to draw some quick conclusions, I know you will go very deep and maybe this is some superficial conclusions which we may draw right now. What would they be?
Maybe at some point, like my preparation was good and what I was calculating was good. Calculation wise, there were not many mistakes. evaluation also. Sometimes intuitively I felt that I should do this, that. Okay, F4 or something. Okay, I cannot be harsh on myself for being so close. I mean, even this F4, knight G4, it was clearly better for me. I don't know, it's too quick to draw any conclusions. Maybe finishing off, I have to...
Yeah.
Maybe I should have had more time. And the reason I did not have time was as taking a lot of time when I had two good continuations. In earlier cases, I had many times similar, like C4, Rook C1, I had to find small differences. Sometimes I have to take more decisions intuitively and then have more times when it's time to finish him off. I lack time to calculate all the way till the end. So here, yeah, I mean, Rook C1, I cannot be, I mean,
that's
I don't know what
easy.
To say. It's not easy at all. Yeah.
Maybe
here I should have played the other line, what I felt was right. This one, it's easier to play.
Yeah.
Maybe here I can tell myself that I should have played this. Here I can be harsh on myself, but to find that Rook C1.
Yeah, I think this Queen F7, Rook G5, Bishop F6, and give the exchange.
Being more practical, this. Being more practical in time pressure to take decisions. I mean, this is some just rough conclusion. Of course, I'll draw more.
There's this one queen exchange which you thought was going to be really good, but actually
it
turns
yeah.
out that what you did was better.
Apparently, yeah. Yeah, apparently he gets counterplay and more drawing chances. So my analytical conclusion was wrong, and my conclusion during the game was right. That okay, maybe I should keep the option. Very interesting to find out. Hurtful to see that I missed.
Yeah,
such
this
a big
is such a painful game in some ways because you.
But I think I learned a lot from
yeah.
this.
And this is how I think players at the highest level sort of improve. You don't let these games just bog you down. You learn from it and keep moving ahead.
Yeah, these critical moments I have to check more carefully. But I just showed briefly how I do it.
Yes, this is going to be extremely useful for all the viewers who are watching this. So we'd like to thank you for spending so much time first showing on the board and then on the computer screen, and we wish you good luck for your
thank you. I feel like it was a bit of a very personal thing to show my game analysis
but this
process.
Is I think one of your biggest qualities, that you have learned this by practicing, by putting in a lot of effort, and you want to share it with the people. You don't want to just keep it to yourself.
I thought it'll be, because a lot of people asked me who want to improve, who are serious. So I thought maybe it might be useful to them.
Sure. Surely it will be. Thank you so much, Vidit.